Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I'll introduce the new ServiceNow Input node that was added in IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12.0.6. So the ServiceNow Input node is one of six new nodes that were added in 12.0.6, which use the Connector Discovery Wizard. These are all described in the App Connect Enterprise documentation. All of these nodes have a similar look and feel and follow on from the previous nodes that were added in 12.0.5. And we also have tutorials for each of these new nodes that were added in 12.0.6. So in the tutorials gallery, if you search for discovery, then you can see the tutorials that were added in 12.05. And you can also see the new tutorials that were added for 12.0.6, which you can follow through. So I'm going to take you through a demo from scratch. So I'm going to use a ServiceNow input node. So ServiceNow is a cloud-based platform that supports service management for all departments in your business, including IT, human resources, facilities, and field services. Slack is a web-based, real-time, and archived messaging app. You can communicate in open or private channels and send direct messages to colleagues and share files. So I'm going to show how to use the ServiceNow input node to trigger a message flow so that an input message can be received into the flow and process it and then send a Slack notification. So first of all, I'm going to create a test server. And I'm going to specify a vault key. This is so that a credential vault can be created in the work directory for the test server. And the policies, which will be created as part of the Connector Discovery Wizard, will reference the credential vault, which have the credentials for accessing ServiceNow and Slack. So first of all, I'm going to create a policy project. I'll call it Discovery Policies. And I'm going to add a policy for connecting to ServiceNow and a separate policy for connecting to Slack. So I'll specify the work directory. So this will be the work directory of my test server. And I need to specify the vault key. I can check that I've entered the correct vault key, and I have. And now I can click Finish. So the Connector Discovery Wizard is shown here now. And I'm going to specify connection for ServiceNow. So there are details in the App Connect Enterprise documentation for how to connect to these different services. So for ServiceNow, you can follow the link to connect for the documentation for connecting to ServiceNow. And then there is a topic which describes what you need to add in the policy for connecting to ServiceNow. So I need to specify a username and password and the client ID. The client secret and the endpoint URL. So now I'm going to connect to ServiceNow and I've successfully connected. And I can see the different events and actions. So on my node, I'm going to later specify an event for when an incident has been created in ServiceNow so that the message flow can be triggered by a new message for when an incident is created on ServiceNow. So I've specified the connection for ServiceNow. I'm now going to specify the connection for Slack. So again, details on how to connect to Slack is described in the IBM App Connect Enterprise documentation. So I'm going to click on Connect. And for Slack, I need to specify an access token. And I'll click Connect. And I've successfully connected to Slack. And I can see the actions that are available for the Slack request node. So in this case, I'm going to send a message to a Slack channel when a new incident has been created. So I can close this wizard now, and I can see that a policy has been created for ServiceNow and for Slack. So now I'm going to create a new application, call it ServiceNow Demo. I will call for flow new incident reported. Click finish. And I'm going to specify a ServiceNow input node. So I will launch the connector discovery wizard, specify my policy project, and launch the connector discovery wizard so that I can specify which event that the service input node should be triggered on. So I'm going to select incident and new incident. So that has been found, and I can save this to my node now. And so my node properties are showing that the created action has been selected on the object incident. So I'm going to now add a Slack request node, and I'm going to launch the connected discovery wizard for this so that I can specify the action for the Slack request node to send a message to a channel. So I'm going to select send message, and I need to specify the channel that I want to send the message to. So I've selected the channel demo the new node in ACE, and now I can save that. So now the node has the details for Slack for that a message should be created in a channel. So I'm going to now just use a mapping node to transform between the two nodes. And in the mapping node, for the inputs map, I'm going to specify the response schema from the ServiceNow input node. And for the output map, I'm going to specify the request schema for the Slack request node. So I can see the fields that I can map. And for this, I'm going to specify the incident number. And I'm also going to specify the short description. And I'm going to specify the concat function. So I will first specify some text saying new incident. And specify the incident number. And now add another string which says created with short description. And then add the short description. And save that. So the map has been done, and now I can save this flow. I can start the test server. The test server has been started. I'll deploy the policy project, which contains the policies. And now I can start recording the flow. So now I'll put a message into the flow by creating an incident in the ServiceNow Management Console. So here you can see all the incidents that are under the system. I'm going to create a new incident here. And you can see it has incident number INC001013. And I'm going to say a short description like, I cannot access my emails. And now if I submit this, sorry, I just need to specify a caller field. And if I submit this, the incident has been created. And now I receive a notification in Slack to say that a message has been received in the channel. I can see it says new incident, and I got the incident number, created a short description, which says I can't access my emails. So that's been sent. And if I click on view path in the flow exerciser, I can see the data that came out of the ServiceNow input node. So I can see the short description there, and I can see the number as well. And I can see that's been transformed, and I can see the text that's being sent to a Slack request node. And I can see the message that was sent to Slack. So in this video, I've shown how to use the ServiceNow input node and the Slack request node so that when a new incident was created in ServiceNow, it triggered a message flow that was deployed to an integration server in ACE. It received the message from ServiceNow and it sent the details to Slack using the Slack request node.